I will be discussing problem number 13. The balance sheet of Amina Company on 1st April 2015 was as under: building, patent, stock, debtors, cash, and profit and loss account. This profit and loss account is treated as what? Miscellaneous expenditure, and it should be transferred to equity shareholders account. So 50,000 preference shares, 90,000 ordinary shares, 15% debentures, interest outstanding on above, and then sundry creditors. On above means on debentures. Let us look into the adjustment. On 1st April 2015, Pharma Company agreed to acquire Amina Company on the following terms. So Amina is a transferor company, Pharma is a transferee company. So this, now let us calculate, look into the PC. Two shares of rupees 5 each fully paid in Pharma Company to be issued for every 3 shares in Amina Company. Which means that for every 3 shares of transferor company, how many shares of transferee company is issued? 2 shares. What is the face value? 5 rupees. So look into the calculation here. Calculation of PC, payment towards equity shareholders. So for every 3 shares, how many shares? 2 shares. Therefore, how many shares are there? 90,000. So for 90,000, it is 60,000 shares at rupees 5 each, 3 lakh. Next one, 6 shares of rupees 5 each fully paid in Pharma Company to be issued for every 5 preference shares in Amina Company, which means that towards preference shareholders, this is towards preference shareholders. Even for the preference shareholders, they are issuing equity shares. How many? For every 5, they are issuing 6 shares. So how many equity shares are there? 50,000. Look into the preference shares. How many preference shares are there? 50,000. Therefore, 50,000. So how many? 60,000 shares of rupees 5 each. So it will be rupees 3 lakh. So what is the amount due to the preference shareholders? It is 5 lakh. But while paying PC, we are paying in the form of equity shares. How much is the amount? 3 lakh. So which means that you are paying at discount. So discount is a profit. So this discount of rupees 2 lakh, discount of rupees 2 lakh must be shown in realization account. So it should be shown as by preference shareholders account 2 lakh. Now moving on to the next adjustment. Debenture holders to be paid in full in ordinary shares of rupees 5 each and for the interest outstanding in cash. So look into the balance sheet. So 5% debentures. How much is the total value of debentures? 1 lakh. So this 1 lakh is the total amount of debenture value and interest outstanding on it is rupees 20,000. So for rupees 1 lakh, they are issuing ordinary shares. So 1 lakh divided by, what is the face value? 5 rupees. 1 lakh divided by 5. That will be issued in the form of ordinary shares. And for interest outstanding, how much is the interest? 20,000 they are paying in cash. This we have to account in opening entries. The creditors to receive 75% of the sum due to them in fully paid shares of rupees 5 each. So we have to make the payment to creditors. So creditors, they are going to get in the form of shares. That is 75% in the form of shares and 25% in the form of cash. So look into the creditors here. 1,10,000. Out of 1,10,000, 75% should be paid in shares and 25% in cash. Again, this journal entry will appear in opening entries. Prepare realization account, shareholders account in the books of Amina Company and pass entries in the books of Pharma Limited under business purchase method. So this is under business purchase method. So what are the items that we are going to consider? Liabilities, debentures, interest and sundry creditors. Only these three. Okay. The PC calculation, towards the equity shareholders, they are paying rupees 3 lakh and towards preference shareholders, they are paying rupees 3 lakh and total PC is rupees 6 lakh. Now let us look into the discharge of PC in equity shares of Pharma Limited. Then that which means that both for equity shareholders and preference shareholders, they are issuing equity shares. Okay, total is rupees 6 lakh. Now realization account, transfer of assets. So realization account data to concerned assets account. For transfer of liabilities, as I told you, only these three liabilities, as it is amalgamation in the nature of purchase. So then you have PC due, Pharma Company account data to realization account 6 lakh and preference shareholders, as I told you, we are paying the preference shareholders at discount, that is rupees 2 lakh, which is nothing but the profit. Balance account and the balancing figure will be transferred to equity shareholders account, which is nothing but loss. Coming on to the purchasing company account or pharma company account. So first PC due, pharma company account data to realization account 6 lakh. And for PC receipt, you are receiving PC in the form of equity shares in pharma company account, that is rupees 6 lakh. Now equity shares in pharma company account, first for the PC received, so equity shares in pharma company account data to pharma company 6 lakh. And for the final settlement made to the equity shareholders account data to equity shares in pharma company how much? 3 lakh. And for the preference shareholders also you are paying equity shares. So preference shareholders account data to equity shares in pharma company 3 lakh. So the account will be balanced. Now moving on to equity shareholders account, first you have to show the amount due. So equity share capital 9 lakh. And then equity shareholders account data to P&L account, this I told you it is on the asset side of balance sheet, okay. So profit and loss account, which is nothing but miscellaneous expenditure, which I have already discussed. Then equity shareholders account data to equity shares in pharma company, how much you are paying? 3 lakh in the form of equity shares. And realization loss you have is rupees 3 lakh 80,000. Then balance the account. Then preference shareholders account, as usual show the due by preference share capital 5 lakh. But in equity shares how much you are paying? 3 lakh. And what is the realization account amount transferred? 2 lakh. So this is nothing but the profit. So you balance the account. Now we'll move on to the opening entries in the books of transferee company. So first general entry would be for PC due. So business purchase account data to liquidator of Amina company account 6 lakh and 6 lakh. Then pay the PC to the liquidator of Amina company account. So it is rupees 6 lakh. Now moving on to the incorporation of assets and liabilities. So assets taken over account data to liabilities taken over. Since it is an amalgamation in the nature of purchase, the difference should be transferred to capital reserve account, that is rupees 5,80,000. As I have already discussed, in the adjustment, debenture holders are paid in the form of equity shares and for the interest they are paying in the form of cash. So 5% debentures is rupees how much? 1 lakh. They are paid in the form of equity shares. So 5% debentures account data to equity share capital account 1 lakh. And for outstanding interest, they are paying in the form of cash. So outstanding interest on debentures account data to cash account rupees 20,000. If you want, you can pass separate general entry for these two. Now, they have mentioned that creditors are paid rupees 1,10,000. Out of 1,10,000, 75% is paid in the form of shares and remaining 25% is paid in the form of cash. So creditors 1,10,000 to equity share capital 82,500, that is 75% of 1,10,000, and to bank account 27,500, that is 25% on 1,10,000. So these are the general entries.